Hello friends, welcome to Cloudakshay YouTube channel once again, and today I am coming back with another interesting series with DevOps tools. In this series we will learn how to install DevOps tools and how to configure that and how can we implement a complete CI/CD pipeline. We will also do a hands-on on the Java project so we can deploy through the various deployment tools. So now we will start this introduction. In this playlist we will see the tool introduction and the logical flow of the DevOps project and the DevOps tool installation and configuration, how to build and deploy an application on a Tomcat or another deployment server, and also we will hands on a Java project so we can create a complete CI/CD pipeline using various tools. Here are the tools name: Git and GitHub, Jenkins, Apache, Tomcat, Ansible, Docker and Kubernetes. We will use these tools to create a complete CI/CD pipeline with the help of that. And let me introduce some tools about that. We will use Git as a local version control system, and it will create a local space into our VM. It will create a local version control system. And now we will GitHub. GitHub is a remote distributed version control system. We will use this GitHub to push our code and make updated code on the GitHub. So it will store our code on the repo. And Jenkins, we will use Jenkins as a continuous integration tool. It will really helpful to create a complete pipeline with the help of Jenkins. So Jenkins is a tool for the continuous integration. MAVEN, we will use MAVEN for use as a Java code builder. And now we will deploy our artifact into the Tomcat server. We will use here to deploy our Java output or the target file EAR or WAR file for the Tomcat, and then we will use Ansible as a configuration management tool. It will deploy, we will deploy our artifact to Docker container or push it to the Docker hub. So for the container we will use a Docker, and for the container management tool we will use Kubernetes. So now take a overview of our CI/CD pipeline. So first we install Git into our Linux system or in a local machine. Then we will create a GitHub account and configure it to with the Git and the local system. And then it is a completely DBCS system. So we will use this GitHub to push our code. Then we create a Jenkins server on VM, or we can also create on the cloud. And then we will integrate our GitHub with the Jenkins. So Jenkins can pull the updated code from the GitHub. And after doing that, our pipeline looks like that. So when a developer can post a code to the GitHub, so Jenkins can pull the updated code from it. That is the benefit of the Jenkins and GitHub integration. And then we will install Apache MAVEN and set Java environment, and then we can configure and integrate with the Jenkins. So Apache MAVEN can build the updated code from the Jenkins and push it to the Jenkins server as a artifact. And after doing that, our pipeline look like that. So once the developer can push their updated code on the GitHub, and Jenkins will automatically pull that from the GitHub. So MAVEN can build the code and push the artifact to the Jenkins server. Here we use a Tomcat server for the deployment our var or ER file. So we will install Tomcat and configure manager app into the Tomcat. It will use for the Java code. We will see the Java code on the web pages. So after that we will integrate our Jenkins to the Tomcat server. So we will deploy the artifact to the Tomcat server, and it shows a web page on the browser. Once the Tomcat is successfully integrated with the Jenkins, so our pipeline look like that. And in this pipeline, Jenkins will pull code from the GitHub, and Apache Maven will build the code and store it to the Jenkins server. Then Jenkins will deploy this artifact to the Tomcat server. Then once it's successfully deployed, then we are able to see our web pages on the Tomcat server. For the deployment related part, we will use Docker container into that pipeline, and we will install some Docker containers into the VMs, and also we will check what is Docker hubs, what is images, what is Docker file, and the basic command of the Dockers. How to create a Docker hub account, and also we will see create a Tomcat container, Docker container. We will run a Tomcat server on a Docker container, and we will understand about these things, what is container, images, Docker file, and Docker hub in briefly. And then we will integrate our Docker host to the Jenkins, so Jenkins can deploy the application on a Tomcat container. In this pipeline, we will be able to deploy our application on a container. Now Ansible comes into the frame. We will use Ansible as a configuration management and deployment tool. It will do the administrative task on the Docker host, and it will also deploy artifact to the Docker host. Ansible creates a Docker images with the help of Docker file, and then we can post that images to the Docker hub and deploy our container with the help of Docker host. Whenever we execute Ansible playbook to deploy the containers, the containers will pull the images from the Docker hub, which is pushed by the Ansible or mentioned into the Ansible playbooks. After completing this scenario, we will integrate our Jenkins with the Ansible. So Jenkins server can copy artifact to the Ansible server. Once this process is completed, our Jenkins pipeline look like that. And you can see we are able to successfully copy the artifact to the Ansible, and it will create a Docker container with the help of Docker hub with the updated images. In our CICD pipeline is completed, but suppose if our Docker host is lost, or if our Docker container is crashed by some issue, there is no way to recover the Docker container. That's why in this CICD pipeline we also use the Kubernetes. Kubernetes is a container management tool. That's why we use for the container management. Kubernetes have the power of self-healing and scaling. That's why we deploy our application not on the containers, but we deploy our application on a pod. Pod is the smallest unit of a Kubernetes. In this playlist, we will also see the basic component of the Kubernetes and also the workflow of the Kubernetes. And after that, we will integrate our Kubernetes with the Ansible. After installing the Kubernetes, we will integrate with the Ansible. Now our application will deployed on the pod on a Kubernetes platform. So our CICD pipeline exactly look like that. And here Kubernetes will create a pod. I will explain one more time. Suppose our code is updated on the GitHub, so Jenkins can pull the git code from the GitHub, and Apache Maven build the code and send it to the Jenkins server. Now Jenkins server will copy the artifact to the Ansible server, and Ansible can create an image with the help of a Docker file and push the images to the Docker hub. Ansible will give the instruction to the Kubernetes to deploy a pod for run the application. After doing all this setup and learning, you will be good into the DevOps workflow.
If you have any questions or any query, please comment below, and you can also ping me on the WhatsApp number. Check out this and keep share and subscribe this channel. Thank you. I hope this will be a good playlist. Thank you.